Yeah, that one hurts. I mean, I'm not going to deny that. It was, I think it was probably the first time all season I went in the locker room and there was a genuine pain and an emotion because, you know, we know where we are and who we are right now. Haven't won a conference game. We're playing a team that, you know, was 4-1 in conference, picked to win it. And we fought our butts off. We performed well. We executed. And, you know, one more play, two more plays go our way. We end up with a victory and that kind of stings. But, you know, pleased with where we're coming, pleased with how hard we're coming there, and the group staying together and being strong and following instructions, and just got to keep going that way and trust in the process.
Questions?
I guess really for both of you to start, was what's it say about this team that you're not intimidated by the top teams in this conference, that you can really take them all the way nearly tonight, get the win?
I feel like we come out there and we just play strong every time. Like, we just, it doesn't matter who we're facing, like, it's the same game. So, like, we just, like, let's play the principles that we know we're supposed to play, play them the best way we can. We know we can't be 100% perfect, and we know that we're getting better as the season goes on, so it doesn't matter who we play. We just go out there with the same mindset on getting better as a team and just keep pushing forward.
Yeah, I think from the very beginning of the year, what we talked about as a team, that the opponent is irrelevant. What matters is us and being the best we can be. And we prepare for our opponent. We go over what they're going to do. We take away things. But that's part of us being our best. It's not about them. So we don't really care if it's Oregon State or Duquesne or whoever we beat. I don't know who it was. But it doesn't matter. We're trying to be the best we can be, and the opponent's irrelevant. So I don't think you're going to see them ever be like, oh, here comes so-and-so. They're just like, we're trying to do this right.
Shalina, you had a huge game, both on offense and defense, going up against an especially great player in loss. How were you able to win that matchup against, you know, such a formidable opponent?
I love the challenge on somebody. It's nice playing against a very talented opponent. So, like, I don't know. It just makes me work harder and just, like, okay, I know what she does because, like he said, we go over scout and everything. I know what she can do and try to take that away from her and then try to do what I do best as I can do it as well.
For the team, I was speaking to Mountain, and obviously free throw is becoming a key part of this loss. Has that been a frustration team-wide, and moving forward, is that going to be especially focus?
I feel like in the past, we haven't shot that bad for free
throw. So it's all relative, right? So if we're a 31% field goal percentage team, us being a 65% or 67% free throw team, which we are, that's actually pretty good for us. That's considerably better relatively, because 70 is what I'd be happy with. But we shot 37 tonight. So tonight it was a particular problem. Our field goal percentage was higher than our free throw percentage, and that's a little ridiculous.